Hi guys, Amores here. Today we are installing an NVIDIA 7000 series GPU in Windows 98. This is a request from one of my subscribers and I promptly accepted the job since I already have a 7900GS card installed on my Intel 13th gen configuration. Actually, this is a triple boot configuration where Windows 98, XP and Windows 11 are peacefully sharing the same NVMe drive. Let's take a quick look. The average boot time for all three operating systems is about 10 seconds. The last official drivers for Windows 98 were released in December 2005 with support for the 6000 series and OpenGL 2.0. We are talking about 8198 forceware release, which is still available on NVIDIA's website. However, in September 2006, a beta 8269 driver addressing widescreen resolutions appeared out of nowhere, and all the future patches are expecting this very driver to be installed. Actually, we need the modified or the unofficial 8269 driver, which is really easy to find, and it will install with 7000 series as well. By the way, if the installer won't recognize our GPU, we have to install the driver manually. This was the case with my card. And as you can see, the driver installed just fine, but using this driver alone without any patches won't be enough. On some configurations, after installing the driver, we won't be able to boot in Windows 98 again. The safe mode will work. At the same time, our GPU can get installed and everything looks okay until we start gaming. And things can get confusing because some games might run while some other games will crash the system. For example, on this configuration, Return to Castle Alfenstein will run stable with no patches installed.
So what's going on here?
Where is everyone?
Half the castle guard is missing.
That's because the Major just doubled the guard around the dig site again.
Unreal is another title that runs fine. The driver is also responding to our inputs. For example, we can force the vertical sync to be off. So instead of 60 frames, we can get about 800 frames. Why not? In the same time, Quake 2, even in software mode, will crash the system. Right now I'm starting 3D Mark and the system will also crash, even if this time is not that obvious. So I guess it's time to make our GPU great again and reliable by using a bunch of patches made by Rudolf Low. We can find all the necessary patches packed together by searching Win9X patch for 512 NVIDIA graphics cards. Once we have the files, we have to patch the nvcore.vxd, the PCI-VXD, and add another VXD in SYSTEM.INI. This VXD will correctly handle some interrupt requests that otherwise can crash the system. This was the short story. Next, I will present you a 3-minute long story narrated by Rudolf Low. Obviously, it's not him, but some AI voice. Sadly, Rudolf Low passed away 5 years ago, but let's pretend for the next 3 minutes that he is explaining how his patches are working.
512 megabytes graphic cards have proven to be problematical when used with Windows 95, 98, and Millennium. It appears that NVIDIA decided to change their design approach after releasing some 512 megabytes models. Previously, they provided access to the entire video RAM through the memory-mapped I/O space. This approach unfortunately limits the amount of system RAM that can be used by 32-bit operating systems. With the later 512 megabytes cards, they decided to bank memory access through a smaller MMIO space, typically 256 megabytes. the 82.69 NVIDIA driver does not recognize the difference between the reported amount of video RAM and the size of the MMIO space allocated to the card. The driver overwrites the MMIO space above the video card's allocation, depending upon what is in the next 256 megabytes of MMIO space. Your computer can crash or other devices, such as ESB, can malfunction. The driver patch changes the video driver code to properly support the smaller, directly accessible video memory of the car. This provides a simpler fix that can handle more cards and avoids the risk of flashing a graphics card BIOS. The disadvantages are that only half of the video RAM will be usable, and the driver may become incompatible with some earlier video cards. The BIOS patch modifies the graphics card BIOS to report the full size of the video RAM when configured. This has the advantage that the full amount of video RAM is available, and the card will work if moved from computer to computer. The disadvantage is the greater complexity and risk of flashing a BIOS and a reduction in available 32-bit RAM in any operating system. Both patches can be applied to a single system. The full amount of video RAM will still be available. A third patch is provided to disable video option ROM configuration. Some BIOS and graphics card combinations set an invalid option ROM address that confuses the configurator. If you cannot boot Windows in normal mode after applying one or both of the above patches, or it reports an error on the display driver, this patch is probably needed. There is no disadvantage to do this patch if not needed. A set of interrupt fix-up files are provided to handle loss of interrupts due to mishandling of end of interrupt EOI commands by the NVIDIA graphics driver. Symptoms of this problem include mouse pointer freezing, disk write error BSODs, and USB problem. There is a bug in some of the NVIDIA drivers that causes them not to provide a proper end of interrupt EOI signal before returning from their interrupt routines. When an EOE is not sent, the interrupt remains active and no new interrupts for that IRQ can occur. This is likely to cause problems with any device that shares that IRQ. TESTEOI.VXD is a test VXD that can be used to determine if the interrupt EOI bug is an issue with your system. When the bug is detected, either a BSOD or pop-up will appear telling you that TESTEOI detected a missing EOI. Closing the notice will let you continue, but part of your system will still be frozen. If TESTEOI detects missing EOIs, then you will need my interrupt fix-up VXD files. Particularly on newer motherboards, the graphics IRQ is shared with the SATA hard disk controller and or USB controllers. Interrupt failure can cause disk write error BSODs and or USB failure or crashes. Thanks for listening. Omores, back to you.
Oh, thank you. Omores here. So, previously we have installed the test EOE VXD to determine if an interrupt EOE bug is an issue on our system, and it is. Now, any crash will summon a nice blue screen, and at this point we know where the problem is. The solution is to replace test EOE VXD with FIXINTR VXD from FIXINTR.VXD. And this VXD will correctly handle interrupt request, and we should finally be able to start 3D Mark 2001, second edition. Now we are back in Windows. Let's check if FIXINTR is loaded. And it is. Now we should have a reliable NVIDIA 7900GS card running in Windows 98, second edition. Let's check this theory with 3DMark. And what do you know? 3DMark is finally running, and we get some crazy FPS for a card that can be installed in Windows 98. This is the standard test. We not watch it all. Let's go straight to the final results. Well, this is a very good score for a 7900GS running at stock speeds. I did look into 3DMark 2001 world records for this card, and this would be a top 30 result. The difference is that the all other 29 cards are seriously overclocked. This is one of those cards that can be overclocked pretty hard, but I didn't change the terminal pace, so I won't go into some serious overclocking right now. The point is that the driver delivers top performance. I don't think it can get any better than this in Windows 98. I know, on the other hand, we are using much newer hardware to benchmark our card, and this will get us some extra points. And speaking of benchmarks, I did a lot of Quake 2 testing lately, especially on 3DFX Voodoo cards. So let's do a quick test on this NVIDIA 7900GS card. By the way, the benchmark takes only 0.7 seconds. I did test a lot of games while making this video, so I have enough material for something like a part 2. Anyway, with this card we can go crazy on details and resolution for almost any Windows 98 game. This is Max Payne 2 in Full HD. Thanks for watching, stay tuned for the next video.
World was out of joint. I was hallucinating. I had to get away.
Max, the route's clear.
Allow me to present Max Payne. Come on, Alfred. Max, dearest of all my friends.
Payne?
It's yours to get out.
You're in the middle.
Max, 1-1.
Sorry, I'll keep
Run!